Given the data set below, we're asked to verify the values of the slopes of each equation. Linear equations describing the change in the median home values between 1950 and 2000 in Mississippi and Hawaii are as follows. Where for both equations, x equals the number of years since 1950 and y equals the median value of a house in the given state. Notice how both equations are in slope-intercept form, which is the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the vertical or y-intercept. So notice how for the equation for Hawaii, the slope is equal to 3,966, and for Mississippi, the slope is equal to 924. But we're asked to verify the slopes using the table of values provided below. Let's first verify the slope for the equation involving Mississippi. Looking at the first two columns of the table, the first row gives us the ordered pair 0, 25,200. The second row gives us the ordered pair 50, 71,400. Now that we have two ordered pairs for the linear equation, we can use the slope formula provided here to verify the slope is equal to 924, where the slope is equal to the ratio of the change in y to the change in x. To keep things organized, let's label the first ordered pair x sub 1 comma y sub 1, the second ordered pair x sub 2 comma y sub 2. So the slope m is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 is equal to 71,400 minus 25,200 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1 is 50 minus 0. Simplifying, this difference is 46,200 divided by 50 is equal to 924, verifying the slope for the equation involving Mississippi. And now we'll do the same for the equation involving Hawaii. For the ordered pairs for this equation though, we'll use the first column and the third column. The first row gives us the ordered pair 0, 74,400. Second row gives us the ordered pair 50, 272,700. Go ahead and label the ordered pairs and use the slope formula. So the slope m is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 is 272,700 minus 74,400 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1 is 50 minus 0. This is equal to 198,300 divided by 50, which does equal 3,966, verifying the slope for the equation involving Hawaii. Now for the second part of this question, we're asked to interpret the slope of each equation for house values using words. Remember, in general, the slope is equal to the ratio of the change in y to the change in x, but in this case, y is the median home value in dollars, and x represents time in years. So in this case, we can say the slope is equal to the ratio in the change in the median house values in dollars to the change in time in years. So let's first interpret the slope for the equation involving Mississippi, which we know is equal to 924. To interpret the slope, though, we want to write it in fraction form and include units. So we'll write 924 as 924 over 1. The units for 924 would be in dollars. The units for the 1 would be year. So because the slope is positive, this tells us in Mississippi, the median home value is increasing by $924 per year. Let's write this as a sentence. We know the home values are increasing because the slope is positive. If it was negative, the home values would be decreasing. And now let's interpret the slope for the equation involving Hawaii. The slope equals 3,966. So we'll first write that as a fraction, and then include units. These would be dollars, and this would be time in years. This slope is telling us in Hawaii, the median home value is increasing by $3,966 per year. Let's also write this as a sentence. We can also see from these two equations, the median home price is increasing faster in Hawaii than it is in Mississippi. I hope you found this helpful.